welcome the second semester learners of the MBA program of KK Hendrick State Open University. In your marketing management course, Unit 12 is all about emerging trends in marketing. So in these three videos, I am going to cover the contents of the unit on emerging trends in marketing. What are the emerging trends in marketing? In this unit, basically, the emerging trends like rural marketing, developmental marketing, social marketing, green marketing, and then services marketing, these are discussed. And these are discussed in the basis of the six learning objectives which are stated at the beginning of your unit. So what I will do, I will take up two of these learning objectives and shall cover the two learning objectives in a video of about 10 minutes. And then within a period of say 30 minutes, we shall cover all the three videos, we shall cover all the six learning objectives. So in this first video, we shall take up two learning objectives, and which is basically about two trends. One is the trend of CRM, the other one is the trend of e-commerce marketing. So two learning objectives are, one is understand the emerging trends in CRM. CRM we have already discussed in your self-learning material. Unit 11 is all about customer relationship management. So Unit 12, once again, customer relationship management has been discussed, but here it has been discussed in the context of the emerging trends. What are the emerging trends? And then we shall also discuss the emerging trends in e-commerce marketing. And then we shall move to the other emerging trends like say rural marketing, social marketing, green marketing, services marketing, etc. in the remaining two videos. Let us first discuss the emerging trends in customer relationship management. You see, in the last two decades, more especially in the 1990s and in the first two decades of the 21st century, last few decades to be more specific compared to the last two decades, we and the last two decades of 21st century and the last decade of 20th century, we have changed the ways and means of conducting marketing activities. Dear learners, I personally attended an international conference in Pune in 1998, and in that conference, one resource person stated, he stated that in future, either there will be e-commerce or no commerce. Means e-commerce will be so penetrating, e-commerce will be so pervasive, and today, as we all have experiences, this is the days of e-commerce. So these two decades, we have seen lots of changes in the technology. Information communication technology, backed by lots of logistics innovations, has made all the differences. So there have been paradigm shifts, mainly because of the advent of digital modes and the changes in environmental forces. From telephone to television, or say telegraph to telephone, it took about 50 years of development. But in the last two or three decades, the kind of development we all have been experiencing, it's not at all comparable, unbelievable. So with these developments, there have been paradigm shifts in the way marketing is being carried out. It does not mean that originally there was no customer relationship management. In the earlier days also, customer relationship management was there. But in today's context, we are having the eCRM. All are digitally enabled. In the days of telephone also, fax, there were pager machines, there was a postal cards. With the help of postal services, there was customer relationship management. There were ways of contacting customers, developing, maintaining relationship with customers. But after the advent of internet and with the help of the personal digital assistants, you see, lots of changes have taken place as far as the eCRM is concerned. Let us see what are the emerging trends or what could be the future trends as far as eCRM is concerned. The number one is integrating data from multiple channels, not only customers, suppliers, retailers, warehouses. A number of stakeholders are involved in the product design, product delivery, service design, and service delivery process. So we need to collect data, we need to collect data, and we need to integrate the data. And that is the call of the day. We'll see lot many activities in terms of integration of data. Supplier data will be related with consumer data. Consumers, from consumers, demand-related data will be taken. From the supplier, supply-related data will be taken. So supply-demand interface, that integration will take place. And that is coming in a big way. For companies like, say, Maruti Udyog Limited, they are mostly dependent on their distributors. They are mostly dependent on their vendors. So the vendors and the distributors, the kind of demands, and accordingly they will synchronize so that they can minimize the cost and so that they can optimize the service delivery process. Handling big data. Nowadays, the organizations are sitting on big data. So handling big data in terms of the database, who are the consumers, when do they buy, why do they buy, who are they, what is their age, what is their other demographic variables, who are our suppliers, how often do they supply, who are our consumers, how often do they buy, who are our retailers, how often do they buy from the wholesalers, who are the wholesalers, right, how often and how many of them buy at what frequency. You see lots of data we are having. So handling big data. Then to that extent, we need to, and many of the organizations are moving to cloud-based customer relationship management. Then another aspect which is taking place, that is a social CRM. Extensive use of WhatsApp, Facebook, and all other, Instagram, and all other digital modes. And moreover, most of the organizations are having their web presence. Then the mobile CRM, the power of the mobile handset, that is being realized day by day. And many of the organizations are making use of mobile handsets to a great extent. And the softwares, the hardwares, all of these have become more and more user-friendly as we have been making progress day by day. So this user-friendliness is also influencing the emerging trend of CRM. Then lastly, another important trend is that from CRM to XRM means not only for customers, with relationship management, we can make anything happen. Suppose grievance. Many of the organizations will try to redress grievances within 7 days. Employee relationship management, it could be. So different aspects are taking care of, are being taken care of with the help of relationship marketing or relationship management paradigms. Then let us go discuss to the other emerging trend, that is the e-commerce marketing. As I told you a few minutes back, that in 1998, when I attended that international conference, there was a saying that in future, there will be either commerce or e-commerce or no commerce. And at that time, we discussed among ourselves that whether a product like, say, Pani Puri, whether a product like, say, tea, coffee, can it be made available through e-commerce? Now, we all have seen with the Uber Eats and so many restaurants having these apps and all this, anything can be made available with the help of internet. So ultimately, we are moving towards mobile commerce, and this is being facilitated by the options in payment. Payment options, ordering options, payment options, delivery options, and a multi-channel model, right? There are delivery boys, plus the big companies are having their warehouses, and those warehouses are being outsourced. Many times they are not managing their warehouses by themselves. Right? The way the Flipkart is doing their business, you can just look around, we can see our own experiences. And it's basically seamless shopping experiences. Anything. You are a pet lover, you are having some pets, so you want to clean the excreta of the pets. So how do you do that? The items are available. Some plastic items are available. So you can order it through Flipkart. You can browse through Flipkart the items available. You can choose the item, then you can order it, and it will be delivered within your doorstep within 3 or 4 days. Just unimaginable. So these are the things which are taking place. Social e-commerce, that is taking place. New features and possibly the new things will come. Say virtual trial rooms. We can check the apparels before purchasing. You can see the new zoom in pictures. 360 degree image view, not just the one static photo. Who knows? Lot many things are coming, and these are the important emerging trends which are taking place. So customer relationship and service is the call of the day when we discuss the emerging trends in marketing. This is the call of the day, and many of the organizations are responding to that. So customer e-commerce uses website for transaction, facilitation of sale of products and services online. And ultimately, it is helping the consumers. Consumers can avail convenient, informative, personalized experiences. So mass customization has become a reality because of the advent of eCRM and e-commerce. And all of these things have influence because the cost of retail floor space is coming down. Many of the things are digitally available. Staff and inventory can be reduced. Many of the things can be outsourced. Logistics services can be optimized. So we are availing new benefits. And these are some of the emerging trends in marketing. We shall discuss about some other emerging trends in marketing in the remaining two videos. Thank you.